Good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining me once again on my YouTube channel. Today is March the 19th of 2021, and I'd just like to once again welcome anyone who hasn't been to my channel, that I hope the messages you are hearing will encourage you to look to the Lord and put your trust in Him, to make a decision to follow Him, because it will be the best decision you've made in your life. The word I'd like to share today is one the Lord had given me personally. However, He wants me to share it with others because it's universal. We know that our mind is a battlefield. All of us struggle with negative thoughts, negative thinking. We don't always have a positive outlook on life and on circumstances. When we're going through trials and challenges in life, we can very easily become discouraged and disappointed. And these things are not healthy for us. So we have to realize that the battle rages on, and as any battle, spiritual battle, it is between good and evil. So we can either have thoughts of health and prosperity with a positive outlook toward the future, or we can walk around with thoughts of doom and gloom. And the way we think does determine our actions. It determines our expectations for the future and our outlook on life. But the good news is that the Lord has made a way for us to overcome, and that is to overcome our negative thinking. And He Himself challenges us in His Word to take a positive stance on our circumstances and on the way we view things in life. So I hope this word will bless you as you hear it, to know that there is help. And it may not be easy for some if they have spent years giving in to negative thinking. However, there is hope. I'd like to begin by reading a few scripture passages. Philippians 4, 8 through 9. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. So this scripture encourages us to focus on positive things and to focus on the things the Lord has taught us. And as we put them into practice, we will have God's peace. So this is one tool to overcome negative thinking. 2 Corinthians 1, verses 19 through 20. For the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who was preached among you by us, by me and Silas and Timothy, was not yes and no, but in Him it has always been yes. For no matter how many promises God has made, they are yes in Christ. And so through Him, the Amen is spoken by us to the glory of God. So these verses encourage us that God has made promises toward us. And these promises, of course, are of good things, and that they are for sure. All His promises are yes and amen. There's no doubt about them being fulfilled. So if we can come into agreement with His promises, this is another tool to change our thinking and to come into alignment with His will and purpose for our lives. Mark 9, verse 23. Jesus said to him, "If you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes." Now, this scripture I find to be a very encouraging one, though a difficult one to apply. The Lord is telling us that if we believe, we will see these things. So this is another tool to believe for the things that we don't see and to stand on them by faith. I'll begin reading the word. "I am at the door knocking. Let me in. I want to transform your thinking, says the Lord. Whatever is lovely and of good report, think on these things. Fill your mind with the positive. You will see how quickly your mindset changes. Restructure it with the word of God. Hear the good news and let go of the bad, for I am able to redefine life, to put it into right perspective. I challenge you to take on a positive outlook on life, to see things from my perspective, to see them as I see them, for my ways are high, beyond your comprehension. Kings and kingdoms will topple, but my word but my word remains forever. I challenge you to believe my word, the word of victory, says the Lord. Come into agreement with my word. It is powerful to the tearing down of strongholds. It will bring to nothing those things that rise up against me and my plan to bring victory into your situations. For I have called you to victory. Press in and believe the promises. Access them by faith. Stand on them, no matter what you see. So what is it I have told you? What is my word towards you? What have I said regarding circumstances? I am the overcoming one. I overcome every negative circumstance. I turn it around for good. So do not believe a lie, but believe that I am at work to bring down strongholds, to break their power, and to set the captives free. That is what I came to do. I came to bring freedom. So trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding. Acknowledge me in all your ways, in all your situations, and I will make your path straight. Better days are ahead, says the Lord. I am opening doors to the future. I am opening doors to renewal. Hearts and lives will be renewed. Hearts will turn to me. So do not focus on the circumstances, but focus on the word. This will cause the circumstance to change. Receive the word, embrace it. It gives life. I want to teach you and instruct you. I want to show you how you can effectively shift circumstances by speaking my word over them. This is my word to you, says the Lord. Do not fret, do not worry. I am adjusting what needs adjustment. I am removing the sting. Greater works will be accomplished. I am releasing a deluge of my spirit that will literally purge and bring life. Signs, wonders, and miracles will be performed in your midst. I will pour out my power and demonstrate it. You will see demons flee, the blind healed, and the crippled walk, for I am launching my missiles of hope upon despair. So let go of despair, says the Lord, and watch the radical move of my spirit bring freedom. Join with the angels and sing hallelujah, for your God reigns. Triumph over the enemy. Come into agreement with my word and ride the wave of my spirit, says the Lord." So this word encourages us once again to keep our eyes on Jesus, on the finisher and perfecter of our faith. And the Lord wants us to live by faith and not by sight. And he recognizes that the battle is in our minds. If we can believe for His promises to be fulfilled in our lives, if we can believe His word and stand on it, we will see victory in our circumstances. We will be able to overcome negative thinking and to have a positive outlook on life. Thank you for listening today, and may the Lord bless you in all your ways. Till next time, bye for now.